What's going on, guys? It's your buddy MLC Stealth, and today we have a double striker MOAB with the striker. I guess I already said that, but this was actually almost a 100 plus game. I went 95-5, so close to that 100. One day I will eventually get that 100 plus game with the specialist only. I feel like the double MOAB is probably going to help me get to that goal. But anyways, today we have this, and I don't know why that guy didn't die. But anyways, a lot of people are probably gonna say, "Oh, it's a striker. That's so overpowered," which. Yeah, probably, but I was using the Silence KSG for a lot of games, and you know what? I was just upset. I wanted to kill everybody and everything, and the Striker helped me accomplish that goal. So I decided to throw it on and kill everything. And I am playing on Bootleg here, which Bootleg is probably like one of the best shotgun maps, especially a Striker map. But yeah, the Striker is still Strike. It's still shotgun. There's still going to be people like with long-range ACRs who are able to kill me, so... At the end of the day, even though this gun is strong, it's strong for a shotgun. It's no assault rifle. You can't shoot people across the map. So yeah, I'm using the Striker for that reason, just because I wanted to kill people. I apologize if you think it's overpowered. I kind of a bit do too, but oh well, I'm using it. And yeah, we're playing on Bootleg, like I said, probably one of the best shotgun maps. My biggest tip for this map, this is probably the biggest tip imaginable, and I actually ran out of Striker ammo right here, which... That, like, never happens. So my biggest tip for this map is you have to have B. If you don't have B and you're playing Bootleg with a shotgun, you're going to have a tough time using a shotgun, because if their entire team is spawning out in the street, oh, you're probably not going to be able to kill anybody or anything. Luckily, my teammates this game were able to kill and capture flags. I think they actually, like, triple capped at one point, which I kind of would have loved if they didn't do so, but it's whatever, I guess. But yeah, these guys were able to capture B. If you have teammates who don't capture B, the enemy team's going to be all over that thing, and you're going to be sitting at A and C just double-capping them and not being able to do a thing with your shotgun. So many times that same thing has happened. It doesn't really, like, matter the skill of the other players. They could be, like, bad or good, but if they're sitting out in B, you're not going to be able to get close to them with a shotgun. It's kind of unfortunate. Luckily, this game we managed to capture B, and Bootleg. Bootleg is an amazing, amazing map, and I actually almost died with that Predator missile. Not sure where he was shooting that thing, because I blind eye hide all the specialist stuff. But as I was saying, Bootleg is definitely one of the best maps if it's played correctly with a shotgun. And oh dear goodness, that guy should have knifed me. He walked right past me. He didn't even like do anything about it. I have no idea what that was all about. But good news, everyone. And by good news, I mean horrible, horrible news, everyone. And, oh, I should have actually killed that guy a little bit sooner. I didn't even, like, see him AFK in the corner. So, horrible news, everybody. As of today, January 24th, 2012, I've heard that the damage extended mags glitch was actually patched for all shotguns. And, or on the Xbox, at least. I heard, like, on PC and PS3, it's already been done. But on the Xbox, I heard it just now got done. And that's kind of lame. Let me tell you, shotguns were kind of already sucky, and now they're even more sucky. Woo! But yeah, the Spaz 12, that thing's probably a piece of poop now. Especially the KSG, just don't even go near that thing. But the Striker isn't going to be as strong anymore, which is probably a good thing. Like, this thing was just amazingly powerful already. But the Model 1887 is left unchanged. I like to look at the brighter side of things. A lot of people are saying, "Oh, extended mags is gone." But the Model 1887 is still there, and it never had extended mags anyways, so I'm going to be using that. Or am I? Probably not. I'm probably just going to go to, like, submachine guns. But I don't know what I was shooting at right there. There were too many things and too many people, and I was just not paying attention to anything. But, yeah, they are capturing C, which I probably could have let them capture C. When you're playing games and you know you're going to win, there kind of comes that moment where you're like, ooh, should we let them have another flag so this game can go on longer? Because... Honestly, 100 plus games are kind of all about just letting the other team have flags and making the game last like 13 minutes instead of like 8 minutes, which granted is kind of like a little cheap. So if you see somebody like triple capping the entire time and he gets like 70 kills, then that's probably like a better game than somebody who like had a 13 minute game where he got like 100 kills. So yeah, I just wanted to randomly say that. But so yeah, we saw that I got the first MOAB right there, and I think I actually... don't get the second MOAB this streak. I think I actually end up dying right here, and then I get up like later on in the game, like right before the game ends, which, oh, a triple MOAB would have been fun. I don't think that's ever been done yet for a domination game, which would be exciting to have happen. But anyways, today A lot of you might know, but I do have school on Tuesdays and Thursdays, and today is a Tuesday. And I'm actually doing this commentary before class, before college. And once I come back, I will upload this video and have lots of love with all you guys. But yeah, I do have class on Tuesdays and Thursdays, which that is the good thing about college. You can just like have all your classes on one day. You don't have to go Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, because that's a pain in the butt. So doing Tuesdays and Thursdays is a nice way to having those 4 day weekends every single day. Let me tell you, that's a blasty blast right there. It's extremely fun. Well, it's fun's not probably not the right word to explain school. Oh, it's fun. Let's school. Huh. So I don't know if it's fun, but I do love going into class and learning, because actually one of my classes in college, I know, like, waste of a class this is theater appreciation. And actually right here is where the game, like, lags. I don't know if this happens to you guys, but, like, do you notice I was just, like, I can't do a thing. Like, every 5 seconds, like, there's, like, one frame. And I just had to sit there in the corner and, like, pray to Jesus that nobody killed me. Luckily nobody did kill me, but, that does happen to me sometimes. And it sucks, like, if it happens, like, in the middle of a kill streak or, yeah. But, I died anyway, so I guess it doesn't matter. But, back on topic, one of my classes is theater appreciation, which, like, what kind of class is that? We go into class and talk about, like, movies and like, Lion King live performances and musicals and stuff, and this guy has been in the corner since my last death. Like, what is he doing? I have absolutely no idea. But, yeah, theater appreciation is a pretty fun class. As some of you might know, I actually just quit my job at the movie theaters. I worked there for about 2 years. And I actually ended up quitting just because I'm actually starting to make money off of YouTube now, and it's kind of like matching the same amount that I would get like working at a job. And I have school now. I kind of just want to take a chill pill, focus on school, focus on YouTube. And I don't know, work was getting boring. I don't know. You probably don't want to hear my explanation about why I quit working at a movie theater. But theater appreciation is actually pretty fun, because all we do is like talk about like actors and movies and directing and all that stuff that I'm definitely really into, because I watch a lot of TV shows, and theater appreciation is pretty much like talking about like all of that stuff that I'm like really interested in, and no idea how I didn't die right there, but luckily we're alive, so good stuff. There's a lot of people that final stand this game. Fortunately, nobody had Dead Man's Hand, but there were a lot of final standers, and yay, assists counting as kill. Like, look at that, everybody has final stand. But this is actually the streak where I get the double MOAB, or second MOAB, so that's exciting stuff. But what do I recommend for this map, if you're playing this map? I recommend just staying around the middle here. Like, as you can see, I probably didn't go down to B, like, one time. And if I did, that was probably, like, to capture the flag or to go around. And I'm not, like, fighting out there. I'm not staying out there, because shotguns don't work out there. It's a lot better to stay, like, just patrolling in between A and C, just going back and forth, going back and forth. I do not venture into that B area, because let me tell you, that is dangerous, and jeez. I was shooting at that dude, and I was just missing, and I was like, oh, nope, see, I'm leaving, bye. I had enough. I had enough of my horrible aim and just me not being able to kill that dude. Which, I probably should have actually been a little more rushy, because that probably actually would have gotten me. I don't know why I say pry instead of probably. That's not even a word. I'm a big weirdo, I guess. That probably would have actually got me. I don't even know how to talk anymore. Apparently I should like take a speech or communications class in college instead of theater appreciation. I probably would have gotten that 100 plus kill game if I was a little more rushy. And see, this is the part where they actually captured like B. So they're all like out here. But luckily they all decided to like, entire team, alpha team, move into A. And they all like went into A. And luckily I think this is the part where I pick up the final MOAB. Woo, it is. Yeah, so double MOAB on bootleg with the striker. Not sure if you guys, like, I love playing, I know the striker is overpowered, I love playing with it, and I actually love seeing gameplay with it, even though I know it's, like, a strong piece of poop. It's still fun to play with, it's extremely fun to play with. Hey, the first Dead Man's Hand guy, look at that. It's extremely fun to play with, and it's extremely fun to watch, in my opinion, so I hope you guys think the same exact thing as I do, because I love using this gun, I really do. So you guys have a good day. I definitely hope you enjoyed this striker gameplay, this striker video. And if you did, don't be afraid to give this video a like rating. It helps the channel grow a lot, and it really does. So you guys have a good day. I'll see y'all later. Peace.